keeping him pinned. They're coming from CT. There's a kit, two smokes. They cannot afford to lose players. Cole's already taken down one. Kenny claws it back, trades equal. Want to see the smoke on the site shoot soon. Nex is looking for the bomb. Drops the smoke. It's not perfect. It's not perfect at all. Olof does go down. Cold finds his second. The P250 strong. There's a kit loose. Hunter's still alive with his low HP. And he just doesn't have the time. You're right. Cold Zera takes it. It's his turn for the multi-kill. Let's FaZe take their pistol.
Oof, all right. Well, this is FaZe home turf right now. And it makes sense. This map they've been very, very comfortable on, and one where they get space, they get into the mid rounds. All of their players can be absolutely deadly. Pistol round got close, it got tight.
Thanks, Olofmeister.
Yeah, you do love to see that. Now, with a round like this, it's likely to see G2 bouncing back
with his ramp position. Now Brokey even swinging into his corners. Rotate. Yeah, Jax caught off. Full rotate from Hunter could punish Brokey a little bit. That's something. And they are all so low, three of them low. Nexa could do damage from his palace position. It looks like it's likely going to be containment, if not a weapon upgrade, his priority.
Cold Zero's got them an escape route here. If he can continue forward in halls, they can all exit up through the balcony. They're close towards A ramp as well, so making sure they can hold on to these.
He's going to get it! No.
We did have the NIP versus G2 game on Mirage just the other day. It ended up 16-13, and the woes for G2 were more on within the early stages.
Rain onto Nico, keeping track of the head-to-head.
It's a 2-0 right now for
Kirby stabilizing. Nex has found a very healthy Olof. He's hunting. He wants to finish off the job. The flash isn't enough. Doesn't find the shot. One bullet would have done it. Brokey adjusting. What a lovely finish. Just making sure things don't go too messy. He'll go ahead and collect himself a nice double and put the third on the board. FaZe, time to buy. Excuse me, let me try again. G2, time to buy. I just see Nico's name.
Yeah, it's going to take a couple games.
Give me a couple. Give me a couple. I see Nico. I just keep saying FaZe. Stupid boy.
I had the 100 Thieves thing. I think I called it Renegades for the first tournaments.
That's very well in sight to save.
That should be the right call here. Look at this. They're out of position. The damage is done. There's no utility. Oh, there's a freebie onto Rain here. He's dropped down. Maybe that might spur G2 forward. Nico's found Rain. It is a 3-on-3. Kenny's already tucked in towards A. They've called this one off. So with very little done there, FaZe pick up a big round. That's Jax falling, Hunter out of position. Both kills for Kirby. And they're going to maintain at least three players alive. G2 holding on to this AWP. The two, Nexa and Nico, can both drop rifles. Hunter and Jax will be very happy to get those. Utility looking good.
Now, no one's calling for help. He can hear them. Nexa, freebie. The molly's late. Olof has found one, needs another though. Nexa's still on the site, using that incendiary to keep them at bay. Kirby is left alone after the frag comes in. It's an AWP and it will be the save. FaZe fall in the fifth.
Need to be careful. Look at this. Jax is still towards top of middle. If he chases this, might be able to catch Kirby off guard. Never mind. Just wants that AK. So saving the AWP is going to be great. They can drop that back over to Brokey and they can buy again. Not out of the woods just yet, G2. We'll need to string two in a row. But that was just another slow round. This game today, a lot of these duels are one-on-ones. A lot of damage done through utility, through the smokes as well.
Hey, so Cold and Brokey, once again, just faced with an impossible task. Kenny S has just exploded with a triple kill on your mid.
Damage needs to be name of the game here. FaZe can't
Ouch, yeah, damage catched. Catched. Hello, I'm a 27-year-old man and I'm making a look at this third frag as well. Lovely quick scope onto Kirby, but then hunting the retreating Olof. Look at this jump. Bang. Kirby's Glock and Cold's Deagle walking out the palace into Nexa. Should be clean. And it is. Nicely handled. Closing the gap. Weathering the storm. Only losing one rifle. Jax has got plenty, so can treat himself and even choose between the AWK and the M4. Doesn't seem to be his weapon of choice. Some players are starting to experiment with certain positional AWKs. That's AUG.
Janky.
Janky, exactly. It still means it's a 4v4. Regardless of how much of a mess that was.
They've left Kenny over towards A right now. There's still a minute and 15 left, but they're gambling on the B site. And we can see that there's no indication over there just yet. Jackson, Nexra, work
smoke. So I don't fancy FaZe's chances here.
They're locked in as well. Jax has all the info over towards B. G2 know exactly where to look. And if
to be pressured heavily. Cold needs a clean one. Kirby has found one. Olaf loses his jewel. Cold does keep it level. And now advancing is next up. Big frag. Cold's gone. Kirby trying to clutch up. He picks up the AK. Needs to spray the smoke. Kenny's walking on it. Just shoot. He has knocked him off it. Has he got the time? I think he has just. It's right down to the wire. Kenny, yeah, saves him. 4-4. Very valiant attempt from Kirby there. Just in the nick of time, knocking him off it. By design or by luck. He did manage to knock him off at the last second of that defuse. But look at how this started. They were truly back to back at one point. Look at this.
This feels like it was in a different round. That's hello. How long ago hello. This feels.
He's going to have to be spurred forward on that. And now Rain can see him if he jumps for the info, gets it, gets away. That's the bomb in middle. A control. Clean. Kenny is awake today. 4 kills. Getting the juices flowing on the CT side. G2 did narrowly pick up their map pick and now making a strong case to close FaZe Clan here on the CT start. 5 in a row, one better than the FaZe start.
G2 have built up a massive bank at this point. They're good for a couple of rounds here. As far as buys go, you can dust too. But it comes down to finding those timings and just hitting absolute bangers as Connector will be re-smoked, and that's going to allow Nico a bit more confidence.
Once again, as Rain advanced, Nexa didn't even need to be called upon. With the bomb being in T-spawn, this does just seem like the Hail Mary. Next is even going to be hearing that Palace rotate from Cold Zera.
Well, if he gets the timeout on Cold here, this round's over.
I think Cold will be safe. Always he's picking up.
And almost one at a time they fall. Kenny's going to find yet another frag. That's back-to-back 4Ks from Kenny, right?
Yep. He's definitely doing what he needs to. I want to see how tight of a line this is from Rain. Look, this must be really a slither gap. Is it just a wall? Yeah.
He's actually taking
micro
his time
adjustments.
As well.
Yeah, really good shooting. Ooh, Olaf laying his life on the line. They're taking space. Rain not gonna get caught by Hunter as he actually mantled upon contact. Molly will force him back. Looks like they will be able to get this bomb down default.
Oh, the toes.
Here they come. Double window aggression. He actually made openings in what? Six rounds?
Yeah, they've been getting absolutely beat down. Hunter's forced forward here. Kirby takes him out. Now they have to call it off. How are you getting back in with a 2-on-4? Both segregated in towards Connector. They want to do some damage here, G2.
That's damage. Rain hasn't finished. Jax hasn't finished his meal. Could be vulnerable, and they get another. So two players put on their bottoms, and FaZe will win, but be forced to rebuy 3 AK-47s. You can see that does certainly keep them honest. Keeping the T AWP is something, though. You said Brokey's been quiet. I can say the same. In fact, his scoreline mirrored by that of his ex-teammate, Nico, who did get caught by Kirby's smoke spray.
That was a pace change, right? They obviously went very fast up through Connector.
And that does chunk away at Cold Zera. Another important jewel. Olaf's won it.
Have to plant. There's no utility for this. They have to plant now.
Oh, Kenny getting pushed. And he actually wins it. Close quarters. Go on, Kenny, yes! He's hitting them all. Tries for the style points. Nexa converts it, though. Great stuff. Actually, a triple kill from Kenny. Puts him on 17 as he pushes forward to deny the plant.
It's good to see Kenny on some form. We had him for an interview just the other day after one of their games, and he was very, very self-critical about his performance so far. They've only played a bunch of matches with Jax. This is a great...
And there will be no plant. There will be no sixth round. FaZe just running that clock down to the point where they've practically had to force it in.
So the only gun round in this spree that G2 have been on where FaZe have been able to pluck one away was when it was fast, when it was through Connector, and it was the gamble. It was the two-man window boost getting players up in towards the vent room. It was Kenny solo on the site.
Bomb will go down thanks to Cold Zera, and they have got a lot of space to work with. Nexus behind enemy lines, and Olaf's found him. It's just converting off the back of these first duels. Rain, Olaf delivering on short. Six found, and it keeps them competitive, Chad. Though it sometimes feels like it's just G2 head and shoulders above FaZe Clan, especially with the T side and the way that they are finding these rounds, it's all or nothing with these guys. Not letting go of W. And peeking as the flash popped, and as upon the death of his cousin, Hunter caught on his advance as well. So it is time on at least one. Kirby's gone down. Rain's trying as hard as he might. He's just ignored it. Dark. Nexa, the silencer saves him. And it's a cleanup. Impossible for these boys to contribute. Brokey just wondering what he's supposed to be doing. It's over now. Kenny puts the bullet into him, and that's 9. G2 need just 7 to seal the deal in 2, or will FaZe Clan be able to put up a fight to take us to nuke? for a duel at that range, and Nico's P250 finds another head. They're kept level. Brokey tested, though, as he catches a Goosh. Working with low HP, doesn't stop him peeking into another.
Trying to pivot right now.
It's getting awkward, especially because Cold can at any time take a glance and hit another shot like that. Ooh, Hunter's playing with fire. He meets Coldzera. They are doing it. Solid stuff from FaZe. Cold has won them this round, or at least made it incredibly difficult for Nexer. He's got no armor. He's taking a chance. If he goes across, he knows Cold will hold it. No, good shooting. Two of them low now. Makes the Glock a viable weapon for this.
This is winnable.
It's not going to be easy. A fake. And an attempt. Another fake. Brokey down. Olof coming from CT. He's pushing in. Nexer needs to be ready for the close quarters duel. Olof wrapping around. Nexer on for the 1v3 long range Glock. Frags, and now he's challenged. He gets away. Smoking a kit, though. Olof can apply a lot of pressure. He's holding it. Oh, what an unsatisfactory way to lose out. He doesn't have the lineup. Olof, you ninja, pulls the round back into FaZe's court purely through in utility. A very worthwhile investment there.
G2's going to have a very scary buy here. Nexer can go with an AK hen armor for himself. They can drop AKs around for the others. Look, Nico's even invested with an AK and Kevlar. So if you have a look at what type of buy G2 are going to have, it's going to be so much stronger than what FaZe could even possibly muster on their seat.
G2 want to take control of this early. Unwilling to let that pistol round. You're building block for FaZe Clan. It pays for itself. That's huge. Not only the round, but three kills. Rain was pulling out nades. That's how unprepared he was.
Yeah, and you could just see that buy from G2. As soon as Nexer stays alive, he gets the bomb down, he gets all those kills. You know he's going to have an absolutely amazing gun round coming forward into round number two. AK and all these different committed locations. Like, Kenny had pushed up so far there. Still have a minute 10 left in the round. Coldzera is on with a frag here.
Hard one. Galil could be the difference maker.
They've left him on an island, though. Look at this. One towards window, two towards B.
Look
he's
at the
about
mini
to
map.
Get sandwiched.
Oh, that's
being applied from G2. FaZe are being punished here. Locked completely in. Hunter through the underpass. Nico covering off short. They've already got Jax towards spawn. There's nowhere that they can really run and hide.
And there's so much time on that bomb.
Last second nade. The ditch attempt. Brokey goes down. Now going into the next round to play with the $1,900 loss bonus. FaZe will have to take a save. This is going to be 12 for G2. They're operating with four rifles. They got one SMG in the mix. And they're just keeping it easy. Trading off of each other. Good spacing, good timing. And even a hunt against the Deagles. We don't see that every day of the week, especially.
Job of containing the aggression. Scout Kirby reports one ramp.
I don't even know where they're looking right now, FaZe. They've lost map control here. Just getting melted with these USPs. So this is the 12th. Olof will do his very best to hold on to this AK, but I don't think he's too long for this world. We'll convert onto Kenny. Cleanup crew. Hunter, he's out. He's contained.
I'm still top mid, dude. They're not even bothering.
Yeah, they just want the frag right now, which is quite curious. If he can hit a couple more, this might be a classic Olof round here. They've contained him, right? So Jax has the connector cross. You've got Hunter there and towards.
And Olof will get himself another. Nexus has tagged him up and he's boomed.
All right, well, it got a little bit more costly than I'm sure G2 would have liked, but it's around nonetheless. 12-7, the scoreline here. Control has been taken. One of the big FaZe fraggers needs to wake up. You need the rain to put in another one of those massive performances like we saw.
Lee Nexer, he's even being stared at.
They need to be careful here. They can't give away too many guns. Oh.
Nice.
Oof, I thought there was a moment there where they give up two rifles. FaZe need to start building a bit of a bank. They need to chuck a couple in a row, and they're able to get two AK-47s there. They can now buy in with full utility. Money in question for G2. You can see Kenny and Hunter not operating with a lot. Jax can drop one, so a buy round should be on the cards. I don't think that they will shy away from this one. Scoreline 12-8. Nico's bought in.
Driving seat of this half. Oh, and just a little late arrival from Brokey. He's had Jax slip the net. He has to address it, maybe even save. Yeah, builds a CZ as he retreats. Nico's already in a position to try and punish the save.
I don't think Brokey's going to be ready for this either.
Oh,
Rain
no.
is in so much strife. Brokey yep. goes down the save. It's not even going to muster.
No, but Rain is going to be kicking himself. He checked T. There should be no way in his brain that this death happens. And boop, a UMP takes the M4 away. You said they had to be careful not to lose their rifles in the previous. Well, they've lost them all and the round. Kenny confirms it. 13 for the T side of G2. Looking to wrap this up in two. Dust 2 and then Mirage. The first two maps of the series. That is the shot from Nico. That was against an AWP peeking into Coldzera.
as soon as you have Olof going down without any resistance on B, there's no point for that retake, and they were already trying to save.
A straight up 2-2 split of your remaining pieces, just hoping the puzzle completes itself. Nico was desperate to die, or at least find more bodies, so they can confirm that A is probably where FaZe lie. Jax is pushing through his own smoke. Oh no, Olof. The sound cue was enough for him to cast his gaze elsewhere. It's enabled them to find not only the frag, but 14 here on the T side. And this second half has been all G2. We've only seen two smudges on their record, or two ticks on phases.
And one of them was Olof defusing the bomb in the smoke.
Yes, so, after a Nexa potential 1v3.
Yeah, when you look at the way that the rounds were... And they got Nico the crowbar out to find the openings round after round. He took down Cole, he's taken down Kyuubi. And I think he's taken away FaZe's chances here.
Yeah, their blade looking a little dull.
Look at this one. Jesus.
To get that one tap though, that's not an easy shot to hit. And he's making that palace presence very clear.
Even rotating back to him now. So, hey, ramp is under question, but we can see nobody's home. FaZe have all now tucked in towards middle. All four of them
started in palace. Looks to be finishing here on the A site as well. It's only Brokey with the saved AK. He'll just be holding on to that for a hunt and catches the head of one. Backing away now, mission accomplished. And they'll be putting everything into what could be the final round of this series. Our first game in the IEM Beijing playoffs in G2. Looking very set for the W here. Had Dust2 just been closed out, a couple of those advantages. FaZe managed another one tap just to the dome. His precision is otherworldly.
Oh, okay.
Uh-huh.
Ah, I see.
Ah.
Exactly. Nexa can grab the bomb at any point and go straight up cat. Destroying the rotation. Look.
Way. He's fallen to Coldzera this time, so maybe they can close it out, but with the absence of the kit, Olof's coming from mid a bit too late. There is a kit for him to pick up should he find Hunter, but he's already caught Nico. Would need another. Oh dear, Olof. He's been hunted down. 9 HP for Hunter to clutch it. Maybe Cold's got a chance, but is he going round the world? He'll opt for connector. It's planted for him. No kit. You bang on, and he's even got a nade. Cold, no, not like this. Balled over, and it's perfect. G2 advanced in the playoffs. They will see the semi-finals, and doing so with Jax as well. Two playoff runs with two different fifth man. Nico's going to be happy. He's taken down his former team. FaZe jersey justified in his cupboard.